Hello everyone, this is Savan Singh from Informatica GCS MDM support team. Today I will be presenting video KB on ActiveVoice Designer. So today's agenda, we are going to discuss about ActiveVoice Designer installation. I will provide a background on how to how do you go ahead with the installation of ActiveVoice Designer, which is inbuilt tool or IDE provided along with ActiveVoice product. How to use inbuilt ActiveVoice Designer. So we have inbuilt ActiveVoice Designer, which can be used to deploy your workflow in case if you're not using MDM or you want to use ActiveVoice as a standalone. And third topic which we are going to cover is how to import MDM out of box workflow. So with MDM we provide out of box workflow which can be used for modification or if you want to customize the workflow, it can be used as it is as well. So I will be showing you how to import this MDM out of box workflow in ActiveVoice Designer and how to view them. So first thing which we are going to cover is ActiveVoice Designer installation demo. So you will have ActiveVoice Designer Windows. I'm using Windows 9245 as for this video KB. You will get this installer in network.informatica website. For licensing for license for this particular installation, you can ask or raise a case with shipping team, and they will provide you the designer license file. So we'll start with installation. Once you get the exe file, you just have to double click on it. So it fetches some prerequisite information, and after that it will install the installation part. So it's a very simple setup, but I will go through one step at a time. So once you say next, first thing it will do is ask for a license file. So as I mentioned in earlier, you have to get this license file from our shipping team. So after providing the license file, just click on next. So this is something which you can keep it as default. This is an important part. So as I mentioned in my in the introduction part, we have something called ActiveVoice Designer server as well. So ActiveVoice Designer itself has a inbuilt server which can be used in case if you don't want to install ActiveVoice server and you are only interested in using ActiveVoice and trying to use or test your workflow. So this is an important thing, or you know, a useful thing which you can be used to test your workflows. So usually HTTP port 8080 is used for MDM. If you are not using it, then you can use it. Otherwise you can just change the port if it's open. So I'm just changing my port. And so the next thing it asks for is the destination directory. So it by default, if you're installing in a Windows machine, it takes program file directory. You try to avoid it because usually program file directory has permission issue. Let's give something like D drive or where you have full power. Select the destination directory. Once you have selected the destination directory, and the next thing it asks for is workspace directory. So those who have used Eclipse or any other IDE, all the changes which we make in IDE get saved to a directory, which is only workspace directory. In this case, you can use any workspace directory depending on your choice. So once you have choose, the next thing it asks for is what exactly you want to install. Just keep this as default. Next thing is just it will ask whether you want to create a launch bar from ActiveVoice Designer and other things, which is like a normal installation. Just click on next. As soon as you click on next, it still start installing ActiveVoice Designer. So it will take some time to install, so let's wait for it. So our ActiveVault installation is complete. As you can see, it's a pretty straightforward installation and does not require a lot of customizations. Okay, so I will open it now. So you can go to QuickView and just open ActiveVault Designer. So first time it do take some time because it has to launch, refresh the cache and load the cache. So yeah, so this is how the ActiveVault Designer screen looks like. So this is all about installation. So next thing which I'm going to cover is ActiveVault Designer server. So as I told earlier, we have ActiveVault Design server as well in ActiveVault Designer. So if you go to ActiveVault Designer, you will see something called servers. In that we will have something called new server wizard. So here, when if you remember, I have given port as 8081. So this is the server which will take that port, and you can make use of it. So it asks for JRE and designer home. So just keep it as default if you don't have anything specific to change. Again, it will ask the same thing which you have given earlier. Just click on finish. So once you have done this configuration, you can right click on it and just try to start it. So in the right hand side, if you can see, you will get the logs on it starting, and you can see it as well. So let it complete. So it has some inbuilt BPRs and other things to deploy. So you can track the progress of in startup in this logs. So if you see, the ActiveVault server has started. Once it has completed this task, the status will change from starting to started, which means it has done. The best way to check is to launch ActiveVault console. So you can launch ActiveVault console, which will be running on the top of this server from Designer also. So if I click on this, if you see, you will see the ActiveVault Designer here as well. So if you go to the catalog, I believe it will have some inbuilt BPRs or a set of project which we give by default. So this is the best one of the easy way just to test your sample workflow, or if you don't want to take the pain of installing ActiveVault server. So third thing which I want to cover is MDM workflow, or how to import the MDM workflow. So as you are aware, MDM nowadays is very tightly coupled with ActiveVault Designer for all workflow-related stuff. So we do provide out-of-box workflow, which is available inside the resource kit. So I will give a demo on how to import it and how you can see the flow of it. So here, if you go to MDM directory, under resource kit, if you go to samples, you have sample for BPM. So this is where we have these two workflow. The BMDM workflow is for business entity adapter or workflow adapter. MDM workflow is for subject area based adapter. So you can, whatever you're using, you can just import it. So the way to import is very easy. It's same as what you used in Eclipse. You have to just go to file, import. So in this case, I used the workspace or root directory. So if you click on the browse, you can go to the BMDM workflow project. Just select this, it will take it as a project, and then you have to click on finish. So once you have selected this project, if you see, you will get all the BPL inbuilt BPL which we provide, and you can view them easily. So let me open one of the BPL file. So if you see, this is how it will look like, and you can understand what exactly happened in a one-step workflow. So this way you can make use of other things as well. So this was about how to import the MDM workflow. It is easy to use and out-of-box workflow. If you want to understand the functionality of one-step or two-step workflow, merge workflow, you can deploy it using ActiveWorks Designer, and you will be in a better position to understand how exactly or what steps are being used when you run one-step approval from ITD slash business entity. Hope you liked the video, KB, and I hope it is useful for all of you. We would love to hear from you. You can post your feedback on support.vidasinformatica.com, or you can do it in the Twitter, our Twitter handle as well. Thank you, everyone. Have a nice day.